That's where I do most of my carving. Small stuff right here on a sewing machine table. I also make book covers and do upholstery. I used to have an upholstery shop for 10 years back in the 1980s. I'm going to clean this table off to lay out fabrics and stuff like that. It's an 8-foot table by 4-foot. Could be bigger. Some fabrics are bigger, but this is some of the fabrics I keep down there that I use for covers, and underneath some various tools, toolbox. Chainsaw Bear. He keeps his eye on stuff around here. There's a shed I found on one of my exercise walks up the road, and a bunch of miscellaneous stuff I just moved over there to move the lathe outside. That's what I search for, the hawks and bears, birds. Trail cam I set up someplace sometimes. Live near Baltimore, so that's the Ravens. This is a new addition to the shop. Excalibur 16-inch scroll saw. I moved the lathe off of this table and put it out in the other shop and shed. The window air conditioner there to keep it kind of cool here. Some upholstery boot cover stuff there. Materials I've got to get out of here. 16-inch Powermatic bandsaw cuts up to 12 inches with this extension on it. The extension that comes with the Powermatic, rather than the other ones, you have to buy it extra. And I hook it to this shop vac. Keep the dust down, and open that window and just let it blow outside. And a camera on a tripod if I want to record any of the bandsaw work, which I do a lot of times. And this is my toolbox from the shop. Still got it after all those years. Just have different things in it. Now I got palm tools. Most of my palm tools that I use are over in my pool caddy that Dale Kirkpatrick made for me. And this bunch of knives. So each drawer, never have enough drawers. And this is a sharpening system. Everything in one spot. Spark sharpening system. Took me a long time to reach that deep in my pocket to buy that thing, but now that I got it, I'm sure glad I did. This is a dust collector for any power carving that I do. And some power carving bits. And that's a magnetic strip along the back wall there that I can hang stuff on. And this is full extension drawer glides on there, on this drawer that I made and added to the bottom. And I got two of those in the bottom of this, underneath of this workbench. And this this is a cabinet maker's tool bench, I mean workbench, with vices on each end, on the side and on the end. And magnifying light. A couple power tools here for power tools, yeah, power carving, and Dremel 4000 Fordham SR with extensions on it. And there's another little Craftsman. Razor tip burner. Burning pen for burning with, and that's, I do a lot of painting. I do some carving here and painting, and actually all of my videos. This is actually my video setup for, made out of PVC pipe. Not glued together, just put together, and I made this rail on the top that the camera, so the camera can point down, and turn it on and just go to whittling right down here where you can see what I'm doing. And that, this here is a light box for tracing patterns out of a magazine or whatever. If you see something you like or you want to trace it, put it on and turn on that light, and it helps you to be able to see through it and make a nice pattern. And of course I always need a hair dryer where I'm painting at. And this is a flap sander that I hooked to a drill motor. And it's got a special clamp for that. You can buy them. And just always keep a spray bottle full of water also around for painting. Keep your control moisture. And I hang up photos to go by. Stuff I want to carve, always I can look right up and look at it as I'm carving. There's a few. I didn't carve that duck that came from up at Haverty Grace, and a couple of carvings I bought in Mexico when I was drunk. You always need a ladder and a broom for sure. And this felt sander, I usually take that out and put it on the railing of the deck. Oh yeah, this is also a laundry room. So let's go outside to the outside shop. It's a shed. It's a mess out here, but you'll have to forgive me. I moved the lathe out here and I'm in the process of straightening it up. But got a small air compressor and a power washer. That's my steam machine for steaming upholstery. About to tighten it up and makes it fit a little bit better, improves the fit. If it gets chilly, I crank this propane heater up in here. Keeps the chill off. That's a workbench over there, believe it or not. It's under there somewhere. And a bench grinder. Another shop vac. This lathe I got from Sears back in, I think, 2000 or 99, something like that. It's variable speed, and it's electronic variable speed, so it's nice, I like it, and of course I need a hand truck, because I'm too old to be humping stuff around. This is my contractor's table saw. Comes with on wheels, and you can take it on a job site if you want, or I can take it out and saw or see the plywood or something like that. Stuff that's big. That's another thing I bartered for with the guy that was closing the shop. It's a drill press. Wood model. Heavy son of a bitch. Use my language. And here's a chainsaw. This is a steel 170. I got the Canon quarter tip bar. So getting in there and doing detail. Some little jigs for holding stuff while you're drilling. Another toolbox I got from Harbor Freight. Pretty darn sturdy box for the price. It's a cheap, pretty cheap, but it's heavy duty and I like it. And of course you can't have enough clamps. I don't really make too many cabinets anymore. I just made I made those drawers for my table inside there, and a little welding stuff there. There's those boards I was looking for, because I'm going to start working on these for since Jordan Stricker made some videos. I'm going to go by his videos. This is couple more chainsaws up there. One's electric. And these are some tools for taking care of the boat and truck. This also has a drawer in there, full extension for the parts there, stuff for the grass trimmer, and this grass trimmer here, the heavy duty. Yeah, it's a nice little view here. Breeze is blowing right now and feels pretty darn good. And that's it. Hope you like it. Talk to you later.